Welcome. Not my speak nerd, y'all. I'm trying to explain how to get through and use GitHub with the CollabLand dev docs. So basically, GitHub can be super intimidating, but there's just a couple of different parts that all fit together. What I've got here is kind of the overview of the kind of workflow that we use here at CollabLand for the dev docs. I'll just kind of walk you through this step by step with callouts to each individual part. But starting off, all the actual docs live on GitHub, like the actual files that we were going to change, they live on GitHub, which is what creates the website. So like, this is the docs website, docs.collab.land. Okay, and then I can find the dev docs. I'll give you the link in the description, but you can also find the dev docs because on each of these pages, there's this edit this page inside of the dev docs. There's this edit this page, which opens up GitHub in the CollabLand dev repo. So that's the repository that we're using to edit the files that are then hosted on this website. Okay, so find the repository on GitHub. I've already done that. Boom. It's the CollabLand dev repo. I'm going to get this, and we're going to use that URL. It's going to come in a second, though. So with GitHub, first, the way it works basically is there's a local version and there's a remote version of all the files. Remote is like lives off in a server somewhere. That's the part that actually creates the website. That's the remote version. So first thing we need to do is we need to get the remote files into our local environment. We need to download all of the files that make up the website. We need to clone the remote repository to local. Now, how do we do this? Well, if you're an actual dev, I don't know why you're watching this. If you're an actual dev, I don't know why you're watching this video. But if you're like me and you're just getting started with this stuff, your easiest bet is going to be to use something called GitHub Desktop. GitHub Desktop is basically just a GUI, a graphical user interface for how to interact with the version control software Git and all the files that live on GitHub. Okay, so basically, you download this, set it up. It looks something almost exactly like this. And then I've already got some repositories cloned locally, but for you, you're going to add clone repository. You know, just pause this video, come back after you've installed GitHub Desktop, and then we'll get started. Okay, you're back. Let's do this. So you're gonna click this up here, just like on Discord, the kind of left in towards the right. So this is like the most general, then it gets more specific. So Discord has like server list, then channel list, then the actual contents of the channel. In GitHub Desktop, we have the repository, then we have the branches in that repository, and then the various things that we could do with that repository. I could fetch things from the origin. If I had changes that were saved locally, I could push them to remote, and all those kinds of things. But for us, let's go ahead and let's add clone repository here. Let's do it by URL. And this is where I said we want that URL that I said we were going to come back to later. Let's copy that URL, put it in here. I've already got a local version of this. I've already done this because I've been working on it. But you go ahead and paste that URL in there and then hit clone and it'll download everything to your local machine. Hit clone and then join me again. Okay, you've got your local files here now. So okay, you've got your local files now. In other words, you've got somewhere on your computer that has the actual files for this repository. Okay, I've got, you know, docs, all kinds of upstream, all this kind of stuff. I got those locally stored. So now I want to actually edit those. I want to make actual changes to the contents here. I want to make some edits. If we come back to our flowchart here, I've cloned a repository to local, and I'm talking about editing branches, the branch files locally now, which you're going to do in a text editor, or a code editor rather, I should say. So you're going to open in your external code editor. I have Visual Studio Code already installed. That's the one I'm using. If you have another code editor that you preferred, you can set that here in options. You can change your external code editor that you prefer. Notepad++, does that come default? I know Notepad comes default, but Atom's another good one. But or you can download your own preferred version of a code editor. But you can open this up. Notice I'm on the master branch right now. the master or main, as it might be called, is like that's the main production one. That is the one that is the end all be all, the live version of your code. Do not make commits directly to the main or master repository. Do not do that. So what we're going to do instead is, following this flowchart, we're going to check out or create a new branch. A branch is basically like a different version of those files on your local machine. Again, because that's what Git is like version control software. So I'm going to create a new version and I'm going to edit that version. And then when I'm convinced that that's done, I will later on, you know, so I'll make a new branch, I'll make a new version, then I'll edit those files. Then I'll make saves, I'll commit changes to the branches, I'll push changes to remote. Finally, when I'm satisfied everything is done, I'm good, I will create a pull request. And that what that does is it says, hey, internet, hey, server, take the branch, the files that I created locally that I pushed to the remote, so they're now living on the server, take that version of those files, and we're going to merge it with the production version. We're going to merge it to main. You cannot push to make merge requests typically, so instead you're going to create a pull request. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's come on back. We're back over here. Let's check out a new branch. So in GitHub Desktop, what you're going to do, just click up here, new branch, and you can call it whatever you want, tester test. And if you put spaces in there, it creates them with dashes for you. This is kind of the best practice. I'll create a branch here. Remember how I said this is kind of like everything that you can do with your branch? So now here it tells me, hey, you got to publish your branch. I have to tell the remote about your branch. I have to tell the remote that it exists. Cool, I'll publish it. I haven't made any changes yet. And I could create a pull request. I haven't made any changes, so there wouldn't be nothing in that merge. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open the repository in my external editor. I'm going to open here. Boom. And this is, again, this is VS Code here. This is Visual Studio Code. You might have your own preferred editor. We've got these things along the left. Again, it goes least or most general to get increasingly more specific. So this is like the different main menus, different context menus. You have Explore, which is looking through the actual repository files. You have Search. You can search for anything. Source Control. This is what you're going to use to make commits. Run and debug. We're not going to be using that because we're just doing docs, but if you're creating code, you'd use that. Extensions, if you want to add extensions, and you can chat with other people in your repo. I can also see here, I've got tester test. That is the branch that I'm currently have checked out. There's also the master branch and all this stuff and a bunch of these other branches in here. So make sure I'm on tester test. I can come in here. This is really what it's going to show like for you. Come over here to explore. Let's open a file. Let's say I want to make, I don't know, I'm just going to open something here. Let's do something from key features. Sure, let's do the GM pass here. So the GM pass, here's a bunch of stuff now. This is inside of the actual text file, gmpass.md is markdown. So almost all of the stuff inside of this docs repository is markdown. So you want to get familiar with that. I have some resources for you attached to this down here inside of this. You can check that out. But let's come on back here so I can make some changes here. Say I want to say this is a change. So now it tells me, hey, there's this little circle here. It's like, hey, you haven't saved yet. So if it says I have one unsaved file because I have gmpass.markdown, I could save this, Control S. Now notice there's this popped up in source control. What that's telling me is I've made some changes to this particular file. I can click this to open that file up. So now I'm not just looking at GMPass, I'm looking at the working tree. I'm looking at the changes that I made to the GMPass file. In green, green is an addition. And if I were to delete something, say I deleted this, save, go into here. I can see red is for deletions, green is for additions. Let's say I wanted to make these changes on remote. I want to save these changes to the remote server version of these files now. So what I'm going to do is I need to make a commit to do that. I've saved it, which changes it locally, but I need to commit it. So what we're going to do is we're going to stage it. In other words, we're going to move these changes from my own local development environment to the local production environment. So we're going to stage these changes. And then from there, put a message in here. I made a change and we're going to commit it. So what a commit does is basically saves your change as a diff, a differential, you know, a difference between the version it was and the new version. And it saves that as like, hey, do this whenever that file gets uploaded to the remote. So sync changes tells me there's one thing that goes up, because again, there's one change that I've made locally that I need to push the commit to origin/tester/test. So I need to push it to the remote. I can do that to sync. Again, I'm doing all of this in VS Code. It's really nice. You can also see that happening inside of GitHub Desktop. So history, you can see I made a change is right here. Here's the change I made. I deleted this and then I added this. And I did this on the gmpass.markdown file. Okay, you might have a bunch of different changes on a bunch of different files, whatever, you make your changes. Let's say you're finally done making changes and you're ready to make those changes to the remote. So we saved, we committed, we pushed our branch to the remote, or it's called sync. You saw it was sync inside of VS Code. So now we're gonna create pull request for branch. Do this in GitHub Desktop. I just create pull request. GitHub Desktop's nice. It kind of shows you like the blue outline. Hey, do this next, which is actually how I learned it. But create pull request. It's going to open up GitHub. I'm not signed into GitHub on this account. So let me open up one where I am. So I created the pull request here in my GitHub account. Yes, you'll need a GitHub.com account as well. You definitely need that. GitHub Desktop is going to require a GitHub account in order to do the things of what I was talking about making changes, making pull requests, all that sort of stuff. But we can see the title of my pull request is I made a change. I can assign people to it, so I can assign myself. I can put some labels on it, check the contribution guides to see the preferred best practices for how to do these. Check the contribution guides, and you got to assign a reviewer to it. So you'll probably be putting me. So from here, you would assign someone. I can't assign myself here because this is my account. So, you know, I would assign this to maybe Abhishek or Alok to review my code, review my changes. You're going to assign it to me, and you can assign yourself as the assignees. This just helps you track and get credit for things in your GitHub account, so that when you go to look at your profile, you get these nice, pretty contribution graph. You can see all your contributions for stuff. You can see the different repositories that you contributed to and your contribution activity. Yay! You can give yourself credit for those things. If you're ready, you can just create pull request. Again, make sure you've got your reviewers and your assigners and your labels all set up. And you can also create a draft pull request if you're not ready for someone to review it. Create draft pull request instead. Either way is fine. But I'm not going to do this because I don't actually want to delete these things. So I'm just going to not create this here. And we'll go back to GitHub. Okay, so you've created your pull request now. Spot check and await feedback. Whenever you create a pull request or you are assigned to an issue, any of that stuff, it shows up inside of your notifications on GitHub, which is this little button right here. And it shows up, whee, and you can track. These are issues. I know these are pull requests. These three are drafts. This one is canceled, but stuff to look at. If I go through, let's see. Let's go look at done real quick. There are some that are merged already. But when you go to merge something, let's take a look at this one. There's these checks that show up. These checks are basically checking for broken links, making sure the page builds correctly, running through the linter, all that kind of stuff. These are really helpful for making sure your page builds. If it builds correctly, you'll see these deploy successful. You'll be able to see a deploy preview here from Netlify. You'll be able to see a branch preview URL from Cloudflare. And if you click that, it'll open up the preview version of the website. Notice this is not at docs.collab.land, even though it looks like the exact same content, because this is a test version. But you can check this and then go through and check which files you want to check and look at. We can see this particular one, files changed, did ERC-721 inside of EVM. So if we go back, ERC-721. So this is the test version. I can check through this, make sure it looks correct. And I can add some admonitions if I want, make these callouts look nice and pretty, add relevant links for anything and all that stuff. Speaking of links, you're going to want to be able to reference other pages in the docs. Like see how this one takes me to another page inside of the docs. That's called a relative link. Relative link, or it's an internal link, I guess. But relative links are going to be real helpful for helping us get there. So let's look at how to build those, how to use those. Inside of VS Code, there we go. Inside of VS Code, if I want to reference another page, this is a, like, oh, this is in the working tree. I don't want to do it there. This is a change, and here is a link. It's markdown, so links are nice and easy. You're probably used to this. I could do https://docs.collab.land. Okay, that's a link. Here is a relative link. This one, though, the formatting is the same. It's the actual link content that's different. So let's say I wanted to link to Command Center. I could give it, you know, straight up https://docs.collab.land/whatever/whatever folder it's in/command center. But if this whole repository moves, if we go away from using docs.collab.land, I don't want to have to change the repository. So I'll use a relative link instead. Basically, I'll tell it where to go relative to the rest of the repository instead of the absolute link of here is where it is on the internet. I'm going to tell it here is where it is inside of the repository. To do that, I'll go to the command center and I'm going to copy relative path here, paste that. Now it pastes the full file name, so we don't need the .md. In fact, it'll cause an error if we leave that. And notice the slashes are the other direction. These slashes are pointing to the right. These slashes are pointing to the left or leaning left. These are Unix slashes. These are like Linux style. So we need to replace these with slashes to the right. And the cool thing also about VS Code is it'll autofill or offer to autofill any of the files within that folder. So right now it's in the key features folder. It's asking, hey, which of these files do you want to use? Hit Command Center. I've already got Command Center, so it's kind of unnecessary, but just showing you some cool stuff. And same thing, you know, save, stage, and make a commit. Sync. And I'm on my tester test. Cool. Check your status for stuff using your GitHub notifications. Check the ongoing issues in GitHub. So we can check inside of the CollabLand dev repository here. You can check issues. You can check pull requests. Pull requests, so that's things for reviewers to look at. So that's more my job. Versus issues is like, hey, here's some stuff, help wanted. We might have good first issue, any of those things that will be useful for you to look at. Or, you know, you can come in here and just create new issues if you find problems with the docs. If you find something that needs fixing, just come on in here and make an issue. I'd love to have it. Just, again, throw some labels on here in accordance with the contribution guide and assign it to someone. Or maybe don't assign it to someone and just leave it there with a label is ideal. I think that's fucking it, yo. These in this have some links to help you learn a little bit more about this stuff. You know, GitHub flavored markdown. I kind of went through a little bit of that with the links. Some stuff about Docusaurus, VS Code. You might use Emacs or Notepad++, Vim, Atom, or some other good ones to look at.